XFM News. On point. News on XFM, I'm Chris Otim. The National Unity Platform presidential candidate Robert Kyagulanyi Ssentamu and the FDC's Patrick Amuriat-Oboy have been summoned to appear before the Electoral Commission. The Commission summoned the two presidential aspirants over repeated breaching of election guidelines. The Electoral Commission, acting on the direction of the Ministry of Health, have banned mass gatherings that have more than 200 people as a means of controlling the spread of coronavirus. In a letter written by the Electoral Commission Chairman Simon Biabakama, addressed to Kyagulanyi and Oboy, stated that the candidates refused to adhere to the directives despite repeated reminders to do so, and therefore they have to report before the Commission. The NRM Secretary General, Justin Kasule Lumumba, has blamed the party leaders and other members of tarnishing her name by involving her in the embezzlement of funds during President Museveni's campaigns in the eastern region. Party leaders in the region accused Kasule Lumumba of misappropriating funds meant to facilitate the delegates honoring President Museveni's campaigns. The reports indicate that the candidates, the delegates, received 100,000 shillings instead of 250,000 shillings that was in the budget. However, in her response, Lumumba says that these are unfounded rumors because top party leadership approved 100,000 shillings to each delegate except upon the directive of the party chairman, Yoweri Kaguta Museveni.
A decision was taken under the chair of the national chairman that every delegate is given a humble contribution of 100,000, which caters for a simple meal for that particular day, but also public transport. So, late as it is, that's what the party decided, and that's what we avail. In those meetings where the national chairman decides to give people more, he gives a directive there and then, and it is attended to. We work on it in his presence. That's why even the simple 100,000 is announced in his presence. So whoever wants to make political capital around that, you are just disenfranchising NRM. I don't know whether that person wishes well and wishes NRM to win.
The former Bujiri District Woman Member of Parliament adds that due to the COVID-19 issues, the party agreed to change the format of paying these funds from cash to bank accounts.
Funds from the party to support the different structures or individuals, whether candidates or committees, is banked direct to the district account. Every district in NRM has an account. We opened up an account. Funds are sent direct to the district, managed by the district leadership. The signatories are the chairman NRM of the district, the treasurer, and the administrative secretary.
Former security minister and the 2021 presidential candidate, retired General Henry Tumukunde, has promised to help the fishermen on Lake Choga. The fishermen at Karagwa landing site in Serede district say that they have suffered a lot with the army on the lake in the name of enforcing good fishing practices. Tumukunde, in response, promised to build the biggest fish processing factory in Serede district to help the fishermen in adding value to the fish and also create employment, as well as solving other problems such as poor roads.
I want to put the biggest fishing factory in this area. And I'll do you one tarmac road that covers all these areas up to your place. I'll also do a special good school in this area because you are in the corner of nowhere.
Nine people have been arrested in connection to the unauthorized concert that was held yesterday in Dungu Resort in Munyonyo, that's in Kampala District. Those arrested include the Nigerian artist Stanley Oma Dida, alias Oma Le, artist Tamilade Openyi, alias Thames, and Muyiwa Amonyini, Temilede's manager. Others include Benjamin Kabura, the organizer, Ivan Dungu, the owner of the place and the manager of the place where the concert was held, and Prim Kasana, the event's manager, who contracted Umale to sing. Nine World News. Senior members of the Trump administration will be among the first people to be vaccinated against coronavirus in the U.S., officials say. The officials said some White House staffers are expected to be given the Pfizer-BioNTech vaccine this week. But on Sunday, President Donald Trump said early vaccinations would only be offered in specific cases. The vaccine covers up to 95% protection against COVID-19 and was deemed safe by the U.S. regulators on Friday. The first 3 million doses of the vaccine are currently being distributed to dozens of locations in all the 50 states across the United States. The first shipment of those doses left a facility in Michigan on Sunday, with the health workers and the elderly in line to receive the first shots as early as Monday. In sports, Paris Saint-Germain forward Neymar was carried off on a stretcher with what appeared to be a serious ankle injury during his side's 1-0 defeat by Olympique Lyon. The Brazilian was pictured screaming in agony and clutching his ankle after suffering the injury in stoppage time. And that's the latest XFM News. XFM News on point.